ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على السلام. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وأسروا قولكم وأو اجهروا به إنه عليم بذات الصدور. ألا يعلم من خلق وهو اللطيف الخبير. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. ونشهد أن محمدا بشيرا ونذيرا وعبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد إمام المتقين وسيد المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، قال الله سبحانه وتعالى بالقرآن المجيد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. واذكر ربك في نفسك تضرعا وخيفة ودون الجهر من القول بالغدو والآصال ولا تكن من الغافلين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the book, the final book, the last testament, Al-Quran, remember your Lord within yourself in humility and in fear, without being apparent in speech, in the mornings and the evenings, and do not be among the heedless. Brothers and sisters, today we shall be talking about the importance of remembering our own Creator Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Almighty Lord, the God of the universe, is one. He is gracious, He is merciful, He is absolute, and there is no one like Him. We humans shall glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night in order to get the consonance, confidence, tranquility, and safety against all the threats and challenges and evils in our worldly life. For the purpose, common sense is the requirement of ourselves in our own mind to believe in Allah as the sole creator, as the sole deity. And our heart should be free from all the grudges against anyone among us, except if it is for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not enter in any heart, the heart which contains any grudge against fellow human beings, against fellow believers. So, in order to attain the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by remembering Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give control against transgressions, pride, grudges against fellow humans. Of course, we hate the sins committed by our own brothers and sisters or the humankind. But at the same time, individually, it is our responsibility to hate the sin, but make the sinner reformed so that he doesn't commit sins. We don't have power as an individual to enforce the punishment, not at all. Enforcement of punishment for any sin, for example, rape, cheating, embezzlement, all these criminal offenses are apprehended by the security agencies like in Canada. The same will happen in the Muslim majority countries. We cannot take law in our own hand, but we do have a duty to support the law enforcement agents. We individually as Muslims, if somebody is committing the sin, we have a responsibility to stop it through talking, through negotiation, by convincing. If we cannot do that also, at least we feel bad inside our heart. This capability in a human being will only develop when we are continually mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and mindfulness will not come to us unless we are among the zakirin, those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night. Of course, the biggest zikr is salat, and for that there are special requirements: maintaining hygiene, ghusl, and then making ablution. But before we go further on that, let us see what are the benefits of zikr other than salat, zikr, recitation of the Quran and Asma'ul Husna. And there are many phrases which Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed us with. So zikr keeps away the shaitan and weakens his strength. It is the cause of Almighty Allah's pleasure. It relieves the mind of anxieties and worries, what we face on day-to-day basis. It produces joy and happiness in our hearts. It strengthens the body and the mind. It brightens the face and the heart. It attracts one's sustenance. It induces love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which in fact is the spirit of Islam and the pivot of religion. And it is the source of success and salvation in this world and the world hereafter. He who seeks access to the love of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he should do dhikr of Allah profusely. Just as reading and repetition is the door of knowledge, similarly, reciting and repeating it to remember in the heart and mind of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions our name at the zakir in his gathering, the gathering of who? Gathering of angels. Dhikr is the key to nearness towards Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The greater the zikr, the greater one becomes close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we all know zikr of Allah causes, once mentioned in the code of Allah, as said in the holy book, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرُكُمْ وَشْكُرُونِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. So dear brothers and sisters, zikr gives life to the heart. Zikr is as necessary for the heart as oxygen to a sick, terminally ill person who is about to die, the medical specialist, he will put the oxygen. If we are in trouble, go to dhikr. Remember Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of you. It has been mentioned in hadith, everything rests according to its nature. The heart rests because there is no dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the heart which does not make dhikr of Allah, as if the famine has spread in the heart. Similarly, when the name of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is taken, we have been told by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one who does not send salutation, salawat ala Nabi Muhammad, he is bakhil, miser. So you can understand that, dear brothers and sisters. So why the dhikr, why the remembrance of Allah is so important for us? I just shared the benefits. Why it is important? First of all, we should all know, Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created Adam alayhi salatu wasalam from the very organic soil of this earth. And earth contains many constituents, many elements, we all know about it. But to give the life to that earthen structure of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puffed the soul from height of his excellence. A pure soul without any spot. We as humans exist as a complex creature with earthly body, with earthly requirements, and soul from the Most High. Now there is a challenge in here. When the soul goes, it goes back to the Most High. When the body goes, it goes back to the earth. When the soul goes back, it has to be as clean as it was given to you, but it wouldn't be. In order to make the soul as clean, we require, first of all, iman. We require ikhlas. We require ihtisab. We require commitment to the obligatory tenets of Islam. And we require dhikr day and night. Not necessary, as it has been shown by some of our elders, to make zikr. Of course, for salat we had to have a special arrangement. But for normal zikr, every moment is tahir, hygiene inside. One question me, how you can say that we can make zikr all the time? What about the ladies when they have menstruation? I said, who will stop that lady under menstruation? When she starts eating, she wouldn't say Bismillah. She has to. A moment is tahir inside. Her or his tongue is always sacred, because we have the light. We have the light of Iman in ourselves as long as we trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, in one of the hadiths, it has been mentioned, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there are four that are the best of words for dhikr. And it does not matter with which you begin. Glory is to Allah, praise is to Allah, none has the right to be worshipped but Allah, and Allah is the Most High. Sunan Ibn Majah. What are those words? Subhanallahi, walhamdulillahi, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the one who recites this 100 times in the morning till the sunset, he will be free from the satanic distraction. The one who recites after Maghrib 100 times, he will be free from satanic distractions. Similarly, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned two words which are light on the tongue and heavy in the balance, and beloved to most merciful in the highest. Glory and praise is to Allah. Glory is to Allah the Almighty. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanallah al-Azim. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, he who says, I seek forgiveness of Allah, I turn to him in repentance, his sins will be forgiven. Astaghfirullah, Rabbi min kulli dhanbi wa atubu ilayh. We must clean ourselves every day, 70 times, 100 times and more. There is one dhikr which Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned as Sayyidul Astaghfar. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the prime repentance, Sayyidul Astaghfar, is in these wordings, whoever recited it in the morning and did not get the night to live, such would be among the companions of heaven. Whoever recited it in the night and did not get the morning to live, such would be among the companions of heaven. What are those wordings? Allahumma anta rabbi la ilaha illa anta. اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت خلقتني وأنا عبدك وأنا على أهديك وعديك ما استطعت أعوذ بك من شر ما سمعت أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء لك بذنبي فاغفر لي إنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. Dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, except for the salat, other zikr could be made anytime, anywhere. Why? Because in Surah Al-Araf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, call upon your Lord in humility and privately. Indeed, he does not like the transgressors. Similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions here of remember your Lord within yourself in humility and in fear without being apparent in speech in the morning and the evening, and do not be among the heedless. If anyone thinks that Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot support him in this life and in the hereafter, let him turn completely to the Creator in the heaven and sever his dependence on anyone else in this world. He will then see that this plan eliminates anything that bothers him. Surah Hajj, verse number 15. Dear brothers and sisters, let us moisten our tongues by remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What bothers us, we can try with our hands, with our intelligence, with our knowledge, whatever we can. Otherwise, say at the end, وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَى نَبِي مُحَمَّدْ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَجْمَعِينَ. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulil Kareem wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in amma ba'd. Fa'inna khair al-hadith kitab Allah wa khair al-hadi hadi Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa shar al-umur muhdathatuha kullu muhdathatin bid'atun wa kullu bid'atin dalalatun wa kullu dalalatin finnar. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala al-nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى اللهم علمنا ما جهلنا. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما جهلنا. اللهم ربنا اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين انعمت عليهم خير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. ربنا واجعلنا مسلمين لك ومن ذريتنا أمة مسلمة لك وأرنا مناسكنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين امنوا ربنا انك رؤوف رحيم. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا ان نسينا او اخطانا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا اسرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقه لنا به. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا انت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم انا نسالك علما نافعا رزقا واسعا وعملا متقبلا وشفاء من كل داء. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين.
اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وجميع الموت المسلمين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصلى الله على نبي محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أقيم الصلاة.